If you're a web designer wondering if you should take the time to learn Framer, a whole new tool to add to your toolkit, I made this video just for you. I was exactly in your shoes. I had been hearing so many great things about Framer, people commenting on my YouTube videos asking me why I'm not using Framer. I just never had the time to sit down and learn how to use it. So you can imagine how happy I was when Framer actually reached out to me and asked if they could sponsor a video, because this gave me an opportunity to finally sit down and play around with it and decide whether I wanted to start using it for my client projects. So this is going to be my first time using Framer. It's not going to be a tutorial on how to use it. This is just going to be me kind of jumping in and exploring the tool and getting an idea of what's possible with it. If you're new here, I'm a web designer who primarily uses Squarespace to build websites in. So that will kind of be the lens that I view Framer with. So in this video, I'm going to be building a homepage for a website. I am going to be starting with a template because I want to see like what's possible in Framer, and I don't have that knowledge yet myself. So I think using a template will give me a better idea of that than if I were to just try to build it out myself from scratch. The website that I'm going to be building is for a fictional business for a makeup artist that I actually did the branding for in a previous YouTube video. And I'll link to that here if you want to check out that process. I'm going to be using the logo that I made from that video and maybe some of the pictures and colors too. But for the fonts, I kind of just want to see what fonts are available in Framer. So I'm not going to be trying to add like custom fonts at this point. Since this is my first time using Framer, I'm gonna start by watching some tutorial videos. They sent me a playlist of videos that they have on their channel, just like the basics of getting started and how to use the interface and stuff like that. So I'm gonna just kind of speed run through that before I jump into Framer, just so I have like a little bit of an idea of what I'm doing. Okay, I think I'm ready to jump in and get started. It seems easy enough, but I won't really know until I actually like get my hands dirty. I'm gonna go ahead and just create an account and just jump right in. Okay, here I am inside Framer. Right off the bat, over here, they have some basic layouts that I could start with, which is great if you need a little help getting started. Lots of options to choose from here. They have a bunch of page layouts as well that you can choose from, which is awesome. But I actually want to check out their templates. So let's go over here and do that. So here is the template marketplace. And up here, you can choose the type of template you want. I think photography is going to be closest to a makeup artist website. It looks like they have both free and paid versions. I'm sure you can expect the higher priced templates to be a little bit higher in quality, but for this video, I'm just going to stick with a free template. I actually really love this template. I love that there's like the left navigation. I might want to use this for my own personal website, to be honest. Lots of really cool options here. This one is very cool. It looks like a desktop. This would be so hard to create in other web builders, which just gives you an idea of like what's possible with Framer. Okay, I think I'm going to go with this template. I'm going to change up the colors and the fonts and stuff, but this is a good starting point, I think. As a makeup artist website, I feel like there's going to need to be a lot of pictures, and this website really showcases a lot of pictures. So we'll start with this one. So I'm just going to copy the template into my account. So it looks like this template comes with three different breakpoints, which are basically like different layouts for different screen sizes. So they have a tablet layout and a phone layout in addition to the regular like desktop layout. I believe you can customize the breakpoints too a lot more than you can in other website builders, which is very cool. There seems to be some kind of layer or overlay on top of the text, so I can't directly click on the text. Maybe there is a way and I just don't know, but that's fine because we have this layers panel over here on the left, which is very similar to Figma. This whole layout looks very similar to Figma. I can use this layers panel to find the text that I want to change. I'm going to change up the font. It looks like there are a ton of different styles, like font styles. It seems like you can add as many as you want, which is very cool because in Squarespace, you have a limited number of styles that you can use. So let's play around with some of these fonts. It looks like I need to take off the capitalization though, or I'll just enter in the text that I want. So I'm gonna change up the font. I think I'm gonna use this one, Erica 1. I love this font. So I'm gonna just speed through this and change up the font styles for all of the text on the website. So already I'm able to see like how much more control you have over the design of your website using a tool like Framer. It's just like using Figma. Like you can add as many text styles as you want. You can add as many breakpoints as you want. There's just so much more that you can customize here that you can't customize in other web builders like Squarespace, for example. Like you would have to use custom code, like custom CSS, in order to get the functionality that Framer has just right out of the gate. This is another really cool feature of Framer. So you can create components basically in the same way that you can with in Figma. This is the button component, and you can create hover states for the components, which is so cool. Like, you can just imagine all of the different possibilities. You definitely don't have this level of customization and creativity with other web builders that I've used. We can preview it right here and check out the hover state. That is very cool. Okay, let's go back to the homepage. I'm just gonna continue changing up the text styles here. Now we've gotten down to the footer, which seems to also be a component, and you can tell by the little diamond over here in the layer panel. I only know this because this is the same shape that Figma uses for components. I watched a few tutorials on how to use Framer, but I just feel like a lot of this can kind of be intuited if you already know Figma. So it looks like these little navigation links are also components. So if I go into edit the component settings, I'll switch over to dark mode so you can see it better. Looks like there's this line. So this one on top is the default. You can see over here in the layer panel, there is a line for the default state. The line width is 0, but then for the hover state, the line width is 100%. So when you hover over it, the line grows. That is so cool. If you wanted to do something like this in Squarespace, you have to use custom code. You have to use CSS. It seems like everything that you have to use custom CSS for in other web builders, Framer just has like an easy way to do it, like built in. It's so cool. This is all very exciting. So I'm gonna add an image for the logo. As I previously mentioned, I've already worked on the branding for this. I've already created this logo in another video. So I'm just gonna pop it into here. So now I'm just gonna go in and start replacing images in the template and moving elements around and kind of making things work. I can add in a little gradient here. So many options that are not in Squarespace, I'll tell you that right now. I'm just gonna change up the colors now. I had like sort of a palette in mind, but not really. So you'll see I keep playing around with different colors. But one cool thing to know about the color styles is that you can have as many defined colors as you want. Whereas in other web builders that we've all used, you can only have like 5. Also very cool is that you can like have a grain effect on top of the images, which this template already had the grain effect, and I'm just gonna keep that on there because I love that and I think that looks very cool. I'm just using the eyedropper tool to pick out colors from the images directly, which is another really cool feature. Also very cool that you can add a gradient like this and just customize the gradient. Like, again, this is something that you would have to use CSS to do in other web builders, but it's just built in to Framer. This is so powerful. This is such a powerful tool. So just adding in the final touches here and finishing up. And this is the final result. This is what I came up with in this short amount of time. Like, you saw how quick this was. My mind is kind of blown that I was able to come up with a website that looks like this in the amount of time that it took me, which I think it took me probably like a couple hours maybe, which of course the template was already designed by another web designer. And so it didn't take as much time to design it, and designing a template from scratch of course would take a lot more time. But if you're looking for a simple and quick way to have a really professional and cool looking website, this for sure is a way to go. And especially if you already have a little bit of experience with Figma. I am so excited about all the things you can do in Framer. Like, it doesn't even compare to other web builders out there. I definitely want to start using it for client projects, but I think I want to do a few more practice projects first, just to kind of explore the tool a little bit more and get a little more familiar with it. I was looking at a list of features of Framer and I didn't even scratch the surface of all of the stuff that's possible. The amount of control you have over the design is incredible. You can customize the breakpoints and add as many as you want. You can create components and add variants and customize the hover states for the components. It's basically just like Figma, except once you're done designing the website, it's already built. Like, you don't have to go and build out the website in a web builder because the design tool is the web builder. It's very cool, and I am very excited to start using it more in my workflow. Let me know in the comments if you use Framer, and if so, what's your experience been like using it? Also, let me know what you thought about this design. I always like to ask for design feedback in my videos. If you've been wondering if you should give Framer a try, I hope this video was helpful in showing you a little preview of what's possible with it. Okay, that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!